Hey guys, I thought I'd do a little tour of one of the gardens that we're doing up on the farm here. So this is just one of the personal gardens that we're growing for a couple of us that live here at the farm. I just thought I'd show you how we're doing it and what we're doing. All right, let's go check it out. So we've got Bryce and Mick making new pathways. So we've got all this wood chip that's come in. This is just palm mulch, and we love using that as our pathways. And then we've got compost in the middle. Check out some of these eggplants. This is going amazing. We picked almost a dozen the other, just 2 days ago. Look how big they are. So they're coming on really strong. They're all bending over. I would have liked to stake them earlier, but we did have some stake where they broke those little bamboo ones, so they're just really heavy. But if I lift them up now, I reckon I'll break them, so I'm gonna leave them down there. Got some nice tomatoes. In the background, there's lots of cassava over there. We got some cucumbers down here. We've been picking heaps. So many cucumbers. There's another few new ones. These look like the continentals, so thinner and longer, and a whole bunch of new cucumbers, some snow peas, getting ready for the colder season. So we've got another month of summer, and we've got zucchinis on here. Might trellis them. Rocket, heaps of rocket, and then marigolds up there, some corn, and we've got pumpkins going wild, mixed in with some watermelons, all in this patch. And then whenever it's time to redo these beds, we just open them up and add a bit more compost if they need it. So this is where we've got a compost rose, wood chip, and we just repeat that system. And that's been working really well, so the weeds can't compete with this thick mulch. And then the compost is also, we went 100 mil when we first started. We just had this mesh in the behind the shed, so we thought we'll use that one this time instead of that style, because it wasn't holding the weight of them. Although it was better, but it's definitely so much better getting them up off the ground. This was a bit of a jungle just this morning with cherry tomatoes covering pathways and everything, so it's resetting it, ready to go for another couple of months, and then we get to move into all the winter stuff, and then we do corianders and broccolis and all that sort of stuff. So it's exciting. It's a bed that's about a little patch that's approximately 8 meters from that set of bananas to this set of bananas, and there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 beds that are about 800 wide each, and right down to where Bryce is now, it's about 15 meters long, and we've been getting so much food out of that little patch there. That's an update. So then we'll move into cleaning up this section another day. That one also has 5 beds, but there you can see the pumpkins has been taking it over. And this whole section of bananas is only 14 months old. So I've got pictures. See if I can update this with pictures of when this got planted out. So that was like a mini food forest, a lot closer than we usually do. Usually we do them 8 meters apart, and this one we wanted to try and make it so it was just a little walkway. So these will get cut back, let the sunlight in, and there's some citrus hiding in there. Citrus and understory, and then once we do a big cut through of this area, then we'll add some more higher quality fruit trees and understory plants. And there's the greenhouse over there, and I thought I'd just show you this one last little patch. So this one was where we had flowers last year, and we had a couple of big piles of mulch here, and this one we just brought in the posi track machine and just had him run over. So it's like a sheep compost, sheep mulching, and this had lots of weeds and things, so we've just put mulch over the top of it all. We're gonna let that sit for a little while, and then we'll find our beds under there, or if it's too hard to find our beds, I'm just gonna bring some more compost and lay it over the top, and we'll also have 5 beds. But I might do this in a different pattern here, and we'll do some herbs, some flowers, and also a rotation of veggies. And while I'm looking at this food forest, so this is what we call a food forest. So we've got bananas, there's a coconut in there, this one is coconut, and there's arrowroot underneath, mango over here, sugar cane as a chop and drop, there's cassava over the back. We also had mint. Oh, there's the arrowroot, so we'll use that as a chop and drop. And then what we'll do is, once we do a big cut through of these bananas, so we're harvesting bananas, but we also need to trim these bananas back heavily, so there's only 3 to 4 stems, and then all the rest of the stems will be used as mulch and compost, laid down in beds, cut in half, and then that'll open up the light, and we can put in these spaces, we put better quality fruit trees. So we've left spaces for other trees, but we need to cut the bananas right back in order to let them grow up. So there's a coconut there. Sometimes we use the machete for the bananas, but this tool that Mick's got there, can you show us that tool you've got? So it's just a demolition saw, and it means that you don't have no swinging, so it's not nowhere near as dangerous. And so fast with the bananas, you can get it into really tight spots where a machete, you need to get the swinging action or have the serrated blade on the machete. So it's a really nice tool to do fast. So you can see a stand of bananas like that, mixed, turned into 2 main ones, and then a small one ready to come out. And I've just chopped and dropped the arrowroot. You could be doing it cleaner and easier. This is a nice effective way of getting the biomass down under the ground, opening up the light in here. It's the update of the gardens today. I'll bring you some more updates soon. Bye for now.